Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create colorful illustrative photo portraits and how to quickly make vibrant variations. Before we begin, if you want to know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials, smash that subscribe button and please remember to click like if you like this video. Thank you. Open a high-resolution, focused photo of someone you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. The first step is to separate our subject from its background. There are many ways to do this, depending on the version of Photoshop you're using. I'll go over what to do in earlier versions. However, in recent versions, unlock the background and open the Properties panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Properties. Scroll down and click Remove Background. Photoshop analyzes the photo and creates a layer mask of the subject, masking out the background. We'll make our visible image into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. In CC 2018 and a bit later, open your Quick Selection tool and click Select Subject. This creates a selection of your subject. To refine its edges, go to Select. For versions earlier than CC 2015.5, click Refine Edge. For later versions, click Select and Mask. If you prefer to use Refine Edge, shift-click Select and Mask. I did in-depth tutorials on both filters, so if you want to watch them, I provided their links in my video's description. Click Smart Radius. This detects smooth and hard edges. To adjust the size of your brush, make sure the caps lock key is off and press the left or right bracket key on your keyboard. Drag it over the soft or feathery areas of your subject, such as hair. Check Decontaminate Colors, which helps to remove color fringing around the edge of your subject. I'll leave it at its default amount of 50%. Output it to a new layer with Layer Mask. On versions earlier than CC 2018, just drag your Quick Selection tool of your subject to select it. To remove areas of the selection, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag over those areas. We'll make a new layer below the active layer by Control or Command clicking the new layer icon. We'll fill the layer with black, but before we do, check your foreground and background colors. If they're not black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Since black is our foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Make the top layer active and convert it into a smart object. Control or Command click the thumbnail of the cutout subject to select its shape. Invert the selection by pressing Control or Command Shift I. Make a new layer. We'll fill the inverted selection with the foreground color by pressing Alt or Option plus Delete. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. As I hide and reveal the inverted silhouette, we can see how it tightens up the edges of the hair. Make the subject active, and if your Quick Selection tool isn't already open, click it. Drag it over the inside of the face and the rest of the body. Go to Select and open Select and Mask or Refine Edge. Check Smart Radius, adjust the size of your brush, and brush over the edge of the face that touches the hair to refine it. Check Decontaminate Colors and click OK. Control or Command click the layer mask to select its shape. Go to Select and Save Selection. Name it Face. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Place your cursor over the inverted silhouette and press and hold Ctrl or Command plus Shift, which selects the hair and deselects the rest of the body. Press Q to see it as a quick mask. We need to invert it so the clear area is inside the hair. To do this, press Q again to revert it back into a selection and press Ctrl or Command Shift I. Go to Select and Save Selection. Name it Hair. Then deselect it. Since we saved the layer mask as a selection, we can drag the layer mask to the trash. We can also delete the photo since we saved it as a smart object. Make your cutout subject active and go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Brush Strokes folder and click Accented Edges. I'll make its edge width 2, the edge brightness 38, and the smoothness 15. However, you may want to adjust these amounts depending on the size and resolution of your image. For your convenience, I provided an image that we could use to place inside our subject's face and another image we can place into our subject's hair. Their links are in my video's description or project files. Feel free to use different images if you like. Drag the one for the hair onto the tab of your subject. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down and release. Open your Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. Control or Command click the thumbnail of the hair to select its shape. Open the Layers panel and click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask next to the active layer. Click the Chain Link icon to unlink the layer and the layer mask. Doing this allows us to resize and reposition either of them independently of the other. Make the space image active. We'll resize it by pressing Ctrl or Command T to open our Transform tool. At the top, make sure the Chain Link icon is active between the transform's width and height. To resize your image inside the layer mask, place your cursor over the W or H and drag it to the left or right to adjust its size. To reposition it, just drag your image. When you're happy with its size and position, press Enter or Return twice, or click the check mark at the top. Open the other image we'll use for the face. As before, drag it onto the tab of your subject and drag it down. We'll make a copy of the layer mask and place it next to the image above it by pressing and holding Alt or Option as you drag it up and release. Open the blend modes. To toggle through them, press the down arrow on your keyboard. Pick the look you like. You can always change it later. I'll pick Multiply. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Drag the copy's layer mask to the trash. If you see this message, click Delete to prevent the layer mask from being applied to our image. Open the Channels panel and Ctrl-click or Command-click the head thumbnail to select its shape. Open back the Layers panel and click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection. Make the top layer texture active and change its blend mode to whatever you like. I'll pick Difference. Unlink the layer and the layer mask. We'll rotate the texture inside the layer mask of the face, neck, and shoulders by opening our Transform tool and zooming out by pressing Ctrl or Command 0. Place your cursor outside the bounding box, and when you see this curved double arrow, drag it counterclockwise or clockwise. To fit it back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. Next, we'll add bright accent lines. Make a new layer and name it Hairlines. In CC 2018 or later, open the Curvature Pen Tool. On earlier versions, open the Pen Tool. I did in-depth tutorials on both tools, so if you want to watch them, I provided their links as well. With either tool, make a path that conforms to the contours of the texture in the hair. The Curvature Pen Tool automatically curves the paths. If you're using the Pen Tool, make your first path and don't release your mouse or pen. Drag it out to curve it, and then click where you want the path to go next. To adjust the anchor point, press and hold Ctrl or Command as you drag it. Double-click the Path Selection tool until the anchor points on the path disappear. Open your Pen tool again and draw another path. Double-click the Path Selection tool again to start a new path. Open your Pen tool and draw another path. Continue these steps to make paths over the hair that complement the contours of the texture. With your pen tool or curvature pen tool selected, open a Paths panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Paths. Click the icon at the upper right and click Save Path. Name it Hair. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Open your Brush tool and Brush Picker. Pick a soft, round brush. I'll make its size 10 pixels, but again, feel free to adjust this amount depending on the size and resolution of your document. Its hardness is 0%, and its opacity and flow are 100%. Press Enter or Return. Open your Brush Settings panel by pressing the F5 key at the top of your keyboard. Open the Brush Tip Shape. The spacing is 25%. Click Shape Dynamics. Make all the setting amounts 0%. The Angle and Roundness Jitter controls are off, and set the Size Jitter control to Pen Pressure. This will taper both ends of our paths. We can close the Brush Settings panel now. Press X to invert your foreground and background colors so white is your foreground color. Press P to open back your pen tool and right-click or secondary-click on your document to open the flyout list. Click Stroke Path. Pick Brush for the tool and make sure Simulate Pressure is checked. Hide the paths by pressing Ctrl or Command H. Notice our paths are nicely tapered on both ends. Change the Blend Mode to Overlay and make a copy of the layer. Change the Blend Mode of the copy to Soft Light. Let's place both of these layers into a folder by shift-clicking the bottom one to make it active as well and pressing Ctrl or Command G. I'll name it Hairlines. Make a new layer. I'll name it Skin Lines. Press Ctrl or Command G to place it into a folder. I'll name this folder Skin Lines. Make the layer active and draw paths over the contours of some of the features of the face. Open the Paths panel and Flyout List. Save the path and name it. With your pen tool active, right-click and click Stroke Path and click OK. Hide the path. Open back the Layers panel and change the Blend Mode to Overlay. Make a copy of it and change its Blend Mode to Soft Light. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.